ready to go. Ready to go. Good morning. The time is 9:07. Currently a very pleasant start here in north central Wisconsin. Mostly sunny skies. Temperature of 59 degrees. I'm Chad Holmes. It is our number two at the Chad Holmes Show. Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bowfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO. And on the Civic Media app. And also, again, and good news is that whatever issue was going on with the live stream when it came to Facebook.com and the Bow Falls Radio page has been fixed. And so that means we are both live on Facebook.com and X.com and the Bow Falls Radio page. You can see a video stream of us, and you can also make your comments and join us that way. And you can also join us by giving us a call or a text at 715-382-9297. That's 715-382-9297 to let your voice be heard here on this program on Bow Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. Coming up in just a few minutes, in about, 12 minutes or so, we'll be joined by Paul Michlig at 9:20. Talk Wisconsin sports as we head into another busy sports weekend that will be coming up. But also, as I've been talking about all this week and going through next week as well, Civic Media, very exciting contest. Sconnie Summer Text to Win contest. And we've had a number of winners already, hourly winners, 7 different hourly winners every single day. And then we have daily winners and then the grand prize coming up at the end of next week. Again, what you have to do, number one is, if you don't have the Civic Media app, download it right now. You have time to be part of this contest for this hour. So download the free Civic Media app. All you have to do is go to your App Store, go to your Google Play, wherever you get your apps, search out Civic Media and download the app. And then you open up the app and you'll see all the stations on the Civic Media radio network. And then you just open up the Bow Falls radio page and you'll see on there buttons for the website, buttons to call us up, to email us, and to text. And just click on the button to text and then send in the keyword, and you'll be one word. That's all. You don't have to have an introduction. Just send in the keyword, and then you'll be part of the drawing at the end of this hour. You'll be part of the drawing at the end of the day, and you'll be part of the drawing for the grand prize at the end of next week. And the thing is, if you win the hourly prize or you win the daily prize, you're still going to be part of the drawing for the grand prize. In fact, if you win the hourly prize, you'll still be part of the drawing for the daily prize. The hourly prize is Wisconsin Dells Summer Prize Packs. The daily prize, which is one winner per day, pair of Milwaukee Brewers club-level seats. The hourly winners, 7 a day. So 7 times 5 is 35. 35 times 2 is 70. So 70 different winners for the hourly part of the contest. We have 10 different winners for the daily prizes, because 5 days this week, 5 days next week, a pair of Milwaukee Brewers club-level seats. And then there will be 2 grand prize winners. 2, not just 1, but 2 grand prize winners. Choice of a unique summer staycation getaway, complete with gas to get you there and back. And the choices are Fort Atkinson Cottage on the Lake, including a pontoon boat, Lake Geneva stay at Harbor Shores, Door County stay at the Ridges Inn and Suites. And also, a little bit something extra, but you'll find out when you're the grand prize winner as well. So can't share everything on the air, but some really good stuff, really, really good stuff. And hopefully some of our listeners here at Bow Falls Radio will be the winners of the grand prize. But right now, because every day this week and next week, in the 9 o'clock hour, I give you a keyword to text in and be part of the drawings to win 1, 2, maybe even 3 great prizes. And for this hour, for a Friday. This is a good word. I think this is a good word. It's maybe not warm enough to truly enjoy it, but at some point this summer, we're going to be able to enjoy beach. Beach is the key word. So B-E-A-C-H, beach. So right now, bring up your app. Bring up the Civic Media app. I can't do it myself because I, as an employee, are ineligible to win. But I do have the Civic Media app here on my phone. I can bring up my app, and then it says Civic Media, then it brings up all the stations. It starts with the Shaw. Then it says Mad Radio, WRJN Racine, locally grown radio, Wisconsin Rapids, and then the fifth one down, Bull Falls Radio. Click on Bull Falls Radio, then you see the logo, you see the streams, you see the buttons that says web to bring up the website, email to send us an email, call us to call. Real simple. If you want to call us, you can do it right through your app on your phone, and then text as well. And the text is on the right-hand side. Click on text, and then put in the word beach, B-E-A-C-H. That's all you have to do. Send one word, beach, hit send, and you will be part of the drawing, have a chance to win the hourly prize, the Wisconsin Dells Summer Prize Pack, the daily prize, the pair of Milwaukee Brewers club-level seats, and the grand prize. And again, Wisconsin Sconnie Staycation and Fort Atkinson Cottage on the Lake, including a pontoon boat. Lake Geneva Stay at Harbor Shores. Door County Stay at the Ridges Inn and Suites, complete with gas to get you there and back, and a little bit of extra as well. Really good stuff. We'll draw those grand prize winners coming up at the end of the contest next Friday. But they draw for the hourly winners each day, the daily winners each day, and a chance to win. So again, you have until the end of this hour, till 10 a.m. After 10 o'clock, that keyword does not work anymore, because the next show, Jane Matinere, after 11 o'clock, will have the next opportunity to win, and she'll have a new keyword. But right now, the keyword is beach.
Mm-hmm.
Do you like going to the beach? Oh, but by the way, let me introduce properly Ian Welsh. He is our engineer across the way. He pushes the buttons, gets me on air. You know, if I doesn't push that button, you can't hear me, then I can't do anything.
That's right.
But Ian Welsh with us each and every day. And Ian, good morning.
Good morning, Chad.
Do you like the beach?
I do like going to the beach. I've been there in a while, but I do like going to the beach. When my family and I go down the Gulf Shores, Alabama, and we go to the beach, it's really beautiful down there. Oh my gosh, it was so. I remember the one time that we were swimming in the water, and my sister actually saw a jellyfish just bobbing up and down in the big waves. It was so cool. You're not supposed to touch it though. It was cool to look at.
I had one of the most painful experiences of my life at the beach. A number of years back, I went and visited some friends in California, in Southern California, in the Los Angeles area. And we went to the beach. And it was a sunny day. It was a warm day. It was a beautiful day. Spent the day at the beach.
Nice.
But like an idiot, both me and one of my friends did not have the proper sunscreen on.
Oh.
And by the time we got to the next morning, and the next day we were going to drive across the desert to Vegas to spend a night in Vegas and do some gambling and have some fun.
Right.
But by the time we woke up the next morning, it was as bad a sunburn as I can't describe the pain. I cannot, honestly. I have said,
I had that happen to me once.
It felt like I was cooking or was cooked. You know, you put something in the oven. And you see how it cooks. You know, you see the turkey, how it cooks.
Uh-huh.
It literally felt like I had cooked my body. It was that. It felt that way. And get in the car, had to do the most awkward, get the seatbelt on, because any touch of the skin, it was just pain. And then got to Vegas into the hotel. And that night, I mean, could even just the sheet caused all this pain. So I learned a valuable lesson. If you're going to go to the beach, if you're going to spend some time on vacation this summer, go somewhere else and spend time on the beach, or go to a beach here in central Wisconsin or somewhere in Wisconsin as well, have the sunscreen. Do not just sit out there and try to get a suntan the old-fashioned way without any. Oh, it was a pain that I will never forget. And literally, I know what it's like now for folks that, for turkey, what it's like to be cooked. Because it felt like I was being cooked. And it was just amazing stuff. But so beach is our keyword for this hour. So again, for those folks, again, get that app. Again, those prizes, especially the grand prizes, are really, really cool. And even the daily prizes are really cool. Those tickets for the Brewers, and they're in first place right now by what, 5.5 games. And these club-level seats are just fantastic. No,
these are good seats.
These are fantastic seats, and we give away club-level seats every single day as part of this contest. And then every hour, you can get those Wisconsin Dells prize pack as well. So again, right now and throughout the rest of this hour, text the word beach on the Civic Media app. Again, the Civic Media app, if you haven't got the app, again, it's free. It's a great piece of technology. Just go to the App Store, go to your Google Play, search Civic Media, download the app, bring up Bull Falls Radio, click the text button, and then just one word. No heavy lifting at all here.
Nope.
None at all. Just send in the word beach, B-E-A-C-H, and you got until the end of this hour in order to get your number and name into the bin to be a winner. And if you are the person that draws, again, they take all these numbers and they are all put into the drawing, and then we will contact you based on the number, because we have, you know, when you text us, it gives us your number, and then we'll text you back if you're the winner.
That's right.
So again, do it right now. Send it in. And as I've said as well, it's a contest, because all the hosts want to be the ones that have the most when it comes to the most entries. And we hope that this show gets a lot of entries, and that makes me look good. And we want me to look good, right? I mean,
absolutely.
So again, right now, we're going to come back here in a minute with Paul Michlig. It gives you a minute to get to your phone, download the Civic Media app, and then download Beach. I should say, text us Beach, B-E-A-C-H, to be part of the Civic Media Sconnie Summer Text to Win contest. But coming up next, it is Paul Michlig. We'll talk to him coming up on sports next here on Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. And welcome back. Chad Holmes with you on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bullfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO. And on the Civic Media app. And good to have back after a week away. Went off and had a, what, you go on vacation last week?
Yeah, my whole life's a vacation, right? I was driving over, I was listening. Were you not thinking of Seinfeld? I was thinking of Seinfeld.
Really?
About when you were saying that you were cooked.
Yes.
Do you remember the episode when Kramer was the chicken and Newman thought he was going to eat him?
And he had the head on the...
Yep. Did you put butter on your sunburn?
I sure would have felt better. I mean, again, that was pain. That was a pain. That'll stick with me. That's, I mean, it was, it, I was cooked. I truly was cooked. And no, I didn't have the spices either.
You didn't have the spices on either?
No, I didn't think about that. But I, geez, I mean, I usually think of these Seinfeld references.
Yes, that's all I could think about, right? When you were saying you were cooked.
I was cooked. And I was cooked. That was a pain. That was a pain that I would not want to go through ever again.
Yeah, you're more of a gambling guy.
But it didn't stop me from going to the tables.
I was say, yeah, you're
because,
the inside guy.
Because that night, all I could do was sit. Because basically I sit there. It was playing blackjack at the time. I would just sit there, and all I had to do was tap with my fingers. Otherwise, not move at all. It was pain.
But you had clothes on, because I bet you that clothes was still a touch.
That's why you had to stand still. You couldn't move at all, because any move is like, ah! Well, but, all right, enough of that. And actually, I heard on the news today, it was like 111 in Vegas, and I'm going there in a couple of weeks, so it's like, I got to get ready to handle the heat.
Yeah, you're in air conditioning the whole time.
You're right. You're exactly
you're
right.
You're not. You're just outside, just to walk.
I know. I don't even go outside. It's like the only time. I don't even go outside. It's like, but enough of that. Enough about my adventures.
We like hearing your stories.
My adventures over the years. But Paul Michlig back with us. You had the track and field state meet last week in lacrosse. Number one, did you have to battle any rain? Because it seems like every year there's some sort of storm that goes through there, right?
Saturday, it was raining in the morning a little bit. Nothing hard.
But no lightning or anything like that?
No delays or anything like that. So they everything was moving on as scheduled. When you have that many people there, you really have to be on time and on target and things like that, and they do a good job of keeping everything smooth and sailing on there. Because on Friday you got the Division I in the morning, and it changes every year, but you have Division I in the morning this year and then Division II and III in the afternoon. So there was like, I think we started a half an hour later in the afternoon than Division I must have got. But it's on a time schedule. You know what I'm saying? They're not really messing around. Only thing that happens if they have to redo something or if hurdles or something happens and it gets them off schedule, well, it only takes one little mistake and you're 30 minutes off.
They better be on top of it, because you'd still be there otherwise. I've seen some of these track meets. I mean, if you fall behind, it's really hard to catch up.
It's hard to catch up. I mean, because there's obviously a time of there, but it was beautiful on Friday, and the weather was and the backdrop of lacrosse and the meet itself obviously is something to behold, and you only get so many opportunities to enjoy that, and it's that time of season, isn't it?
Oh, the WIA season. We're getting to the point here now. We get that little timeout, at least for me, because basically from when you guys kick it off in August until. And actually, normally I would still be doing something, but this year kind of ended a little bit earlier, and which is okay. I mean, I counted it up like 135 events, but the same thing with you, because I mean, it's constant. Do you get a chance to step away now? Because you have football, you have track and field, where you're the head man. You've been AD as well. Do you get a chance to take a deep breath, or is it right back into setting up for some summer camps and summer football and everything else that nowadays feels like 12 months a year for both the athletes and for the people that are around these teams as well, the coaches?
It is, and sometimes it's probably unfortunate. The one thing that I hope I've learned over the years is if you don't force your time, you're not going to get the time.
I'm lousy at that myself.
Well, you can't buy time either. That's the thing is, you can't buy it back. So once it's gone, it's gone. And so we got to do a better job. But you're right. I mean, obviously we had, you know, weight room and things in speed camp starting yesterday. And we got 7-on-7 starting on Sunday. And so in camp, the North Central camp is in a week and a half. So all this stuff comes up, you know, and we got the All-Star game coming, and we got our camp coming, and there's so many things that there's always something going on. We had basketball camps this week. The kids are always doing something, so you got to force your time, because you don't get to buy it.
Oh, and it'll be August before you know it. I had a meeting yesterday about the new year of Sully's college football page yesterday.
I talked to him 2 days ago. He was looking for you.
Yeah, I know he was. And he found me.
He found you. He found you.
He found me. So
I don't think you're hard to find.
I'm not hard to find, you know. But and I know that especially once your season comes to an end, you get to be part of that as well, which I always appreciate because I'm carrying Sully all the time. No, it's all fun. It's a lot of fun, and you know
he's all ready to go, and that's
he was excited.
He's excited, yeah. And it's good to, you know, work with people that are excited about what they do.
Exactly, and I know that as much as you know, I'm very lucky to work with a lot of people that are very excited about what they're doing. We got a couple of minutes before our information update, but I guess we'll jump right in because right now, if you don't talk baseball now, you're not going to talk baseball because now it is baseball with the Milwaukee Brewers, and right now they're about 5.5 games still in first place. I mean, those three games in Philly. I mean, Philly right now has got the best record in baseball, and the Brewers had a chance in all these games, but you gotta say, boy, you know, great job of slowing down Bryce Harper and the rest of those Philly hitters, but just could not push enough across offensively.
I think they had five guys. Was it five? Guys thrown out at home in three games,
which is a crazy amount. Yeah,
that's a crazy amount that they just couldn't get those runs through against them. Obviously, they got a really good staff too, pitching wise too.
They keep getting hurt, and yet they just keep on getting.
No, I'm talking about Philly.
Oh yeah.
The Phillies, they have a good staff. I mean, and they went against two of their guys that are really, when they're on, they're on. And they were on, so it's tough. So you stop their hitting, but the pitching was still there, and it's just a little concerning that I thought we'd be able to push a few more runs behind. You know, I was thinking more that we would lose, you know, something like 4-3 or something like that instead of, you know.
We're going to come back and continue, but I would say I'm impressed because you talked about the Phillies pitching staff, and I just pulled up real fast. They've allowed fewer runs than anybody in the National League. So you obviously came.
I was prepared today.
You are prepared.
I'm excited for it.
So you got more to come with Paul Michlig after this information update. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230.
All right, in the next 30 seconds, the Wausau Business Show is going to be open for business. Here we go. We got 30 seconds, Paul. Now we only have 20. I'm Ryan.
I'm Paul.
And we host the Wausau Business Show on Bull Falls Radio every Saturday, 8 to 9 in the morning. This week, we have Tyler Vogt.
Tyler is the owner and operator of Malarkey's, Townies, and the new Westsider Diner and Lounge. And we also have Kyle from You Know You're From Wausau If.
Great Facebook page. And Red Lobster Tattoos. We'll see you Saturday, 8 to 9 on Bull Falls Radio.
98.9.
28. 29, 30, and we're closed.
And welcome back, Chad Holmes Show, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. Live update, Pacelli leads Assumption 8-0, state softball. Saw Pacelli play Newman last week, so Pacelli looked very good. They had both offense and pitching. That's a good combination.
And I think they're pretty young.
And they're pretty young, and they're always pretty good. But so they're leading Assumption in their semifinal game. I was mentioning it earlier because one of our Civic Media stations is out down there covering it. Lucky folks.
I would assume that Pacelli will be moved up next year.
Oh, because
won the state title last year.
The success racial thing. Yeah. No, you're right, and seen a few of those. Not too many, but a few of those. And I think that's the way it's kind of meant to be. That you have to be really good to move up. You have to kind of win State
well,
Chiefs.
In their situation, they're pretty young, too, so that probably...
And you can't come back and say we're losing all of our players, so we shouldn't do that. Because they do have that appeal process you can kind of...
Correct. Not that they ever take that appeal, really, the way it looks. Anyways, I don't think anybody's actually won that appeal.
Right.
Have you heard of that? I mean, I haven't heard of that.
I have not. And there's only one division, eight-player football, so you don't have to worry about that.
Wow. We also didn't win the state title.
No, you did last year. You did last year. But yeah,
thanks for rubbing it
no,
in.
No, you had two. Again, no. Oh, please. Back to back previously. I mean, boy, you talk about a rough stretch here for you.
Life is a struggle, yeah.
Go back to the Brewers. And again, looking at the division standings, and Brewers right now in first place, the only team in the National League Central with a winning record, 36-26. Then you got four teams within one game in the loss column. I mean, just the old mediocrity of the NL Central. I want to ask you about Council because he came back to Milwaukee last weekend and has not been easy. I with baseball, and I think we've said this in the past where you can't make the assumptions and make assumptions on the whole season or on a long term process because baseball is different than all these other sports. The 162 games and even the multi-year model, but it's not been a smooth transition for Council and the Cubs. They've been kind of scuffling, haven't they?
Well, they have a lot of injuries too. I mean, which
everybody's got injuries.
I know. The thing is, it's a long season. My guess is that they'll still be there when it's all said and done. I'd be shocked if they weren't. And sometimes that stuff takes a little time. But you would think that there has to be a little. Coming and losing 3 out of 4 to the Brewers, being behind them by 5.5 in June is definitely not making it a smooth run. But I'm going to say is I'm sure when he jumps into his pile of money, he's probably at night.
Oh,
that he,
there you go.
I know.
Again.
I know you
there
love it.
You
I know
go
you love
again.
It.
Yes. But
because I mean, can you wake up and not be happy? I mean, like if I was him, like honestly. You get to go coach baseball, and you're getting the highest paid manager. I mean, he's got to be a happy camper.
Well,
I mean, he's getting everything
he
wants.
I'm sure he's doing okay. I'm sure. But as a competitor, you know what it's like as a competitor. I mean, you don't get to that point without having that. And again, I mean, some people would say that when you get to a certain level financially, that fire can be dimmed a little bit because you're comfortable. But again, if it was the easy thing, he would have just stayed in Milwaukee. I mean, he would have, again, but again, you're saying that that little extra money was the difference.
Well, you don't think that was the difference why he left?
I don't think it was. I think it was a combination. It helped, but I think he was ready for another challenge. Sometimes after a decade, sometimes, and maybe he felt like the ceiling was higher with the big market Cubs who are going to be able to spend a little more than Milwaukee does.
Correct, and I don't disagree with that. But you got a guy fired.
Yes, he did. No, you're exactly right.
I mean,
you're right.
So
right.
I don't. I mean, if he won the challenge,
Tampa Bay's had really good.
Go Oakland, sorry.
But based on your theories, David Ross is thrilled because now he's getting paid all that money for not working.
Sounds good to me. Are you telling me if you're getting $1 million to sit at home, you would do it?
He's a winner.
Would you do it, Chad? Tell me right now, this second, if they told you to go home and you got paid $1 million, you would say...
You know what would be a fairer way to put it? Not to say I would get $1 million. I would get paid what I get paid now because that's what David Ross is getting paid. He's getting paid what he would have got paid. To say to me, you're going to get paid
the difference is, though,
25 times more than I'm making right now. Oh, yeah, I'm going to take 25 times more.
The thing is, though, what I'm saying is that he's set for life, even if he doesn't get another job. We would still have to go get another job. Do you understand
right.
I'm getting there?
Yes. Definitely have to get another
job. So that's my point, I guess, is that these guys are set for life.
But I just think that you bring that money aspect in way too quickly.
I know. Well, because the thing is that, I mean, he talked. The only reason I'm bringing it up is because he talked about it. I mean, he said David Stearns was after that trade that he – started not trade, but when David Stearns left because of that, I want to say because of that trade.
But he started thinking about
it. He started thinking about it, okay?
Yes.
So then you're going back to like.
But that's, he didn't start saying, hold on, I started thinking about being a free agent so I can make a lot more money. No, that's not what he said.
He said he wanted to be the highest paid manager.
Because he felt like he
deserved that.
But also. To lift every other manager outside of David Ross.
I was saying, as he stepped on the guy's back, as he was going.
When David Ross gets his next job, he'll be appreciative.
He'll be thankful. Yeah, I'm sure he will be. I'm sure he will be.
When he crosses, goes to the White Sox next year or whatever.
Do you think, honestly, I mean, I'm telling you this right now, the manager it does matter. But you telling me that there's 7.5 or whatever he's getting?
Actually, that's a point I was going to try to make, because when you look at Council, so far, and again, they could be win at a 70% clip the rest of the year. I mean,
there's a realistic chance they could.
But my thought is, so far through 63 games, that means they have 99 games to go. I mean, obviously a lot of baseball left to play. But he's not looking quite the genius that he did in Milwaukee right now. And it makes me think how much of it is, because I don't think he forgot how to manage, how much are outside factors, whether it is injuries, whether it is anything else, just being in a different situation. Because you're right. I mean, when it comes to managers, we've seen, I mean, number of records. I mean, Joe Torre became a genius when he went to the Yankees, when he had failed with the Mets, and he failed with the Cardinals, he failed with the Braves, and that was he's a Hall of Fame manager. Well, I mean, was he doing anything differently with the Yankees that he was doing when he was losing 90 games with the Mets early in his career? I think he needs to
get a feel for the whole Cubs and the Cubs organization. Because if you think about the one thing that they do, that the Brewers do, and they've probably been doing it for the last 5, 6, 7, 8 years, whatever, is they manage that bullpen. And you know, they manage that stuff, and they know everybody and how can get guys out and bring them up. And if you don't know every in and out of that organization, it's probably tough to do. My guess is to start off with, until you start learning the land, so to speak, and seeing how it goes. I think that will play a factor into it, because Murphy's still doing the same exact thing.
And it's been amazing. I mean, I mentioned earlier, you mentioned the Phillies and their pitching and how they've allowed fewer runs than anybody else in Major League, in the National League. The Brewers have allowed fewer runs than only three teams, Philadelphia, Atlanta, and the Dodgers. I mean, and when you look at the guys the Brewers have been rolling through.
Who are they?
I know. And so, obviously, there is a system that is working in Milwaukee, because it's not – because sometimes, it's all about the talent. Well, in this case, it's not all about the talent. Yeah. They are figuring a way to make the pieces they have work. And whatever Milwaukee has done, and I think you can go back to the Stearns era, and obviously Arnold worked for Stearns. So the system has been, I think, been built upon. But boy, whatever the system is, and I can't tell you exactly what the system is, they've changed GMs, they've changed managers, and yet the system
seems to
work.
How long has Chris Hook been there?
Oh, that's a good question.
Because he's doing a heck of a job. I mean, obviously, I mean, they brought two guys in.
Yeah.
And they never had no experience. And then one guy got a save, his first save.
I mean, when you talk about pitching coaches and batting coaches, sometimes there's a theory that, well, you can't blame the batting coach for the struggles at the plate. Well, there is a. You're there to try to maximize. And I think that's what Hook and the Brewers, generally for a number of years, I mean, it's really been a long time here that they maximize. So, again.
Do you know I want to know a question without looking at your computer. Oh, who's the hitting coach for the Brewers?
That is a good question. Who is the hitting coach for the Brewers right now?
Come on, Chad.
Can't think about it. Do you know?
No. I just could tell that you didn't know.
No, so I did not. I'm usually pretty good at faking it. I tell you. So you caught me there. People can look at the camera and see my fingers working exceptionally fast. But this weekend, Detroit, you don't want these losing streaks to stretch.
Well, the thing is the problem is that we got pitching. I mean, Gasser's out now too. I mean, who do they have?
I know that's, again, it's like
Now they got two guys coming back, it looks like, in the next couple weeks.
Well, yeah, Peralta tonight. So that's good. You know the thing about Peralta? You look at it again. He just 4-3, 3.74 earned run average. Yeah. I mean, but yet it feels like he's been better than that to me.
He has been lately.
Yeah, but I mean, it's still just it's kind of average.
But he always has one of those, like he'll have two, he had two starts in a row where I think it was one run. He lost both of them. And then the last game, he gave up like four. They end up winning, I think. They end up winning that game against the White Sox. They got off to a bad start. But they must be putting them on short rest because they had a day off yesterday. But they're going against what
skipping
they usually
somebody,
do.
Skipping somebody. Skipping
somebody. Well, because there is nobody.
Right. But usually in that situation, they would go to a bullpen game.
Yes, because he pitched on Sunday.
Right, right.
So that means Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday they played. So, they're definitely putting him on his regular rotation. But that's where we're at. And they don't do that very often.
No, they don't. They don't. They will stay with the system.
The system.
You're exactly right. What else do you want to talk about? Because, I mean, there's a hole here between,
But you got the draft coming up here, the basketball draft
That's
coming
true.
Up in a couple of weeks.
Oh, by the way, one thing I did want to ask, the news came that Giannis is going to play for the Greece. I thought, Michlig's not going to be happy about that.
Well, it's not that I'm not, but you pay a guy a lot of money. I know, again, money doesn't have anything to do with it.
But this is it's a little different because this is more of an investment, and the Milwaukee Bucks are paying Giannis, not the Greece national team. So that there is a difference in that. So don't lump the money thing and say, Chad, it's all about the money. No. I'm a person of nuance. You know that. I'm a person of nuance. So, but I'm a little concerned about that.
And they play early July. They have to play in the qualifier.
Yeah, this is the thing. They got to win the qualifier to get to the Olympics. Do you think that Doc and the Bucks are saying, wouldn't mind if they lost real quickly and they realize, it's not worth it, so we're going to pull them right away?
Yeah. I mean, because, again, if they win that qualifier, then they go to the end of July. You're talking about that whole month of July that he's going to be on somebody else's watch, right? I mean, that's...
And by the way, the Celtics are going to win the championship because the Bucks made that trade last summer.
I know. Wasn't it... I'm cheering for Dallas.
It's not going to happen. Boston's going to win that series. Probably within six games at the most.
You think?
I think.
I'm going Mavericks.
Well, pizza on that one? I like my chances on that one.
Well, that's the first time.
There you go. Well, have a good weekend. We'll catch you next week.
Looking forward to it. You have a great weekend, Chad.
That's Paul Michlig. We'll come back. Our final segment. Number of the Day quiz with Ian coming up. Can he pull out a W for the week? We'll find out next. And welcome back, Chad Home Show, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app with Ian Welsh. I'm Chad Holmes. And real fast, I got to mention as well, again, you got a few more minutes, if you haven't already, to send in the keyword for the Civic Media Sconnie Summer Text to Win contest.
Mm-hmm.
Again, this hour's keyword is
beach.
Beach. Ian was on top of that one.
B-E-A-C-H.
Yep. Beach. That means if you send it in, you'll be eligible to win our hourly prize, Wisconsin Dells Summer Prize Pack, our daily prize, the pair of Milwaukee Brewers club-level seats, and the grand prize, the choice of a unique summer staycation getaway, complete with gas to the Fort Atkinson Cottage on the lake, Lake Geneva Stay at the Harbor Shores, Door County Stay at the Ridges Inn and Suites. So, again, bring up that Civic Media app, bring up the Bull Falls radio page, hit on the text button, and one word, so simple, five letters.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, just B-E-A-C-H, send, and you'll be part of the drawing and a great chance to win. It is the 7th day of June. Can you believe it's the 7th day of June?
It's going by so fast.
I mean, at the end of this month, we're halfway through. This is month number 6.
My goodness.
By the time we get to the 25th, it'll be 6 months from Christmas.
Well, I just focus on one day at a time.
I know. But day number...
I know some people like to prepare for that early.
No.
Not me.
Yeah, go line up outside for Black Friday 4 months early.
Jeez.
Day number 159 of this year, 207 days remaining, and some famous events have occurred on this date in history. On this date in 1966, former movie star Ronald Reagan became the 33rd governor of the state of California. On this date in 1975, Sony introduced the Betamax video cassette recorder for sale to the public. It was the first VCR. Eventually, the VHS format proved more successful.
Mm-hmm.
On this date in 1982, Priscilla Presley opened Graceland to the public. On this date in 1993, singer Prince changed his name to an unpronounceable symbol. On this date in 2014, 10 years ago today, comedian Tracy Morgan was hospitalized in critical condition after his bus was hit by a speeding semi-trailer. Former fellow comedian James McNair did not survive the collision. On this date in 2020, the COVID-19 global death toll passed 400,000. On this date in 2021, a microscopic multi-cleed organism returns to life after being frozen for 24,000 years in Siberia, according to new research.
Wow.
And 1 year ago today, 2023, wrestling legend The Iron Sheik, WWE Hall of Famer, died at the age of 81. Some famous folks are celebrating their birthdays today. Singer Tom Jones is 84. Actor Liam Neeson is 72. Former Vice President Mike Pence turned 65. Guitarist Dave Navarro is 57. Actor Carl Urban played Dr. McCoy in the Star Trek films, the latest ones. Carl Urban is 52. Comedian Bill Hader of Saturday Night Live and The Mindy Project is 46. Actor Michael Cera, Juno, Arrested Development, and a number of other different acting gigs. Michael Cera is 36. And model Emily Ratajkowski is 33 years old today. And if you out there celebrating your birthday, happy birthday to you from all of us at Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. Some famous events are being acknowledged here today.
Mm-hmm.
Among those are Donut Day.
Oh,
I am a big donut fan.
Me too.
In fact, I'm going on vacation in 2 weeks. And one of the best things about my vacation is I get Krispy Kreme donuts, because we don't have Krispy Kreme around here.
Oh, Krispy Kreme.
I love
so
Krispy.
Good.
In fact, I decided, because I made my reservations for a hotel in Vegas,
mm-hmm.
I decided to go to the hotel that has a Krispy Kreme in it. So that was the reason.
That way you don't have to travel very far to get a donut.
Exactly. Along with the pricing of the... But I said, hey, all things being equal, I want to have a place where I can just walk to the Krispy Kreme.
That's an added bonus.
I'll probably have about 20 pounds extra on me when I come back after that.
Maybe you can bring a couple of donuts here to the studio.
There,
so I could have some.
There you go. It is Donut Day.
Mm.
It is Gun Violence Awareness Day. It is Chocolate Ice Cream Day. It is VCR Day. And it is Junebug Day.
Junebug.
Yep, Junebugs. All right. It's all on the line today.
Yes,
it's either
going to
be, it's going to be either be a winning week for Ian, or it's going to be a losing week for Ian, because our number of the day quiz, if you have not heard our number of the day quiz, we give Ian Welsh 3 choices for our number of the day. So you should get 1 out of 3 just based on math.
Yes.
33%. So if you're above 33%, it's a winning week. If you're below 33%, it's a losing week.
All right.
And Ian right now is 1 for 4. 25%, which is below 33%, but
yes,
a win today means 2 out of 5, 40%, and a winning week.
Yes, it does. Okay, I'm ready.
All right. Our number for the day, percentage of adults who say they nap every day. Hmm. Percentage of adults who say they nap every day. Is the correct answer 24%? Is the correct answer 34%? Is the correct answer 44%?
24, 34, or 44% of adults who say they
nap every day.
Nap every day. Okay, I'm going to say, I'm not going to overthink this. I'm going to say B. I'm going to say 34. That's my final answer.
All right. The percentage of adults who say they nap every day is 34%.
Yes.
Give you a hand. Yeah,
got it. Started the week on a good note.
Yeah, pulled it out of the fire. Yeah, earned a W for the week. 2 out of 5, 40% above our 33% threshold. So you can go off, get ready for a big weekend of anything goes with a win in the Number of the Day Challenge.
Still plenty of tickets available if you want to come and see the shows.
And come and see me. I'll be there. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to tell Ian which show, but if you see me, say hello. Hey, have a good weekend.
You too, Chase.
I will see you after the show.
Absolutely. TGIF, everybody. Happy Friday.
Stick around. Coming up next, it's Matt and Air on Air. And again, you have about a minute to go. Send in beach as the keyword for this hour and the Civic Media Sconnie Summer Text to Win contest. Again, beach. You got a minute 15 to go. Have a great weekend. We'll talk to you on Monday.